My why. The reason why I do this work. I was about 9 years old, and I remember reading an article about a young girl who was abused and eventually starved to death by her parents. I remember cutting out that article and taping it to my wall. And all I could do is ask myself why. Why did this happen? Compassion, anger, and even determination is what I felt every time I looked at that article. At my young age, I knew that children should never feel so powerless and should always have a feeling of safety. Along my path into adulthood, I always wondered how and why a child could ever be put in a position to feel anything other than safe and empowered. As I continued to further my education, there was a silent and still passion that grew for bringing awareness to the plight of children from marginalized communities. Children who have no outlet to embrace, find, or even express their voice. And I wanted to advocate for them. I made a decision that a crisis like this should not be normalized, at least not on my watch. The thought of that young girl from that article never left my mind. A young girl who never had a chance to blossom into what she could be, who is gone but definitely not forgotten. A young girl who could have been my niece, my sister, and even my young scholars today. This journey, this soul calling, gives us an opportunity to share in a vision of empowering young scholars who would utilize their voice to affect change in their community and beyond. And because of that, I teach them today so they could change the world and empower tomorrow. And that is my why.